إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم اجعلنا مسلمين صالحين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وتوفنا مسلمين صالحين وادخلنا الفردوس الاعلى من الجنه برحمتك يا رب العالمين ونجنا برحمتك من عذاب القبر وعذاب الحشر وعذاب النار ومن كل عذاب وحساب وعقاب وبعد. Today is Monday and today's date is the 14th of ربيع الاول for the year 1436 of the Hijrah, of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, which coincides with the 5th of January for the year 2015. Monday is designated to study the Seerah, the life of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. If you read in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, if you read in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are going to find with no effort whatsoever how compassionate was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the kuffar, about the disbelievers of all kinds. Those who were harsh, those who were mean, those who wanted everything bad to do to him, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and anyone in between. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam was also so kind to the best that the Sharia will allow. Was so good with the munafiqun, with the hypocrites. When we talk about the munafiqun, the biggest name, رأس المنافقين, the head, the chief of the munafiqun, was Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. His son was among the elites of al-Sahaba al-Kiram, the elites of al-Ansar. And his name is what? Abdullah ibn Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. One in the camp of al-Iman among the elites. And the father is what? In the camp of al-Kufr al-Nifaq. And he was the chief. And Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, his story goes like this. Okay? Why his enmity, his grudges so plentiful? He has a heart of his heart is full of grudges, ill feelings. He was hoping one day to be the king of al-Madina.
Yeah.
Al-Islam came. While they were preparing to make him what?
The king.
Literally, they were knitting his clothes and his crown and everything. So, that is what? First strike is gone. And this Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, he was an impulsive person. He acts on impulse. Okay. rarely he thinks. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Al-Madinah, he refused to be a Muslim, and he was very open in his disbelief, in his kufr. And any time he found any hole to criticize Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to insult Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not let the chance pass. He became a munafiq, as we studied earlier, after the battle of Badr. He said, okay, there is no way we can defeat these people. Let's pretend that we are Muslims. And in our hearts, we are going to remain kuffar. So he pretended to be what? A Muslim. And he did so many awful things. So many awful things. Among them, he is the one. He said, what? لَإِنْ رَجَعْنَا إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ لَيُخْرَجَنَّ مِنْهَا الْأَعَزُّ الْأَذَلِ. If we go back to Al-Madina, the most honorable, the mightiest, will what? Will expunge, will expel from it the most humiliated. In reference to who? To Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. Among his most evil was the fabrication of what? حادثة الإفك. The lie against what? Aisha radiallahu anha wa arduha. Which is, until this very second, the most painful thing that happened and happening to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A whole religion is based on what? This accusation, which is called Shi'azim, Shia. His son was so dutiful to his father, but he was way much dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In more than one occasion, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, I know that my father did such and such. If you command me to bring his head to you, I will. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tell him what? بَلْ بِرَّ أَبِيك. No, I do not want you to do that. What I want from you, with all the emphasis, I want you to be dutiful to your father. Amazing. Amazing. One occasion, he said, Ya Rasulullah, people there is a rumor among the people that you are about to kill my father. If you decide to do so, please let me be the one who kill him. Just pay attention now. Look at his loyalty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then to the believers. How he understood al-Iman, al-Wala' wal-Bara', loyalty and disloyalty. Said, Ya Rasulullah, let me be the one. And he used to be known that so dutiful to his father. If his father tells him, jump, he will say, how high? And this used to be very common among the Arabs. Dutifulness to the parents beyond imagination, but it is with different what? Levels. And Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul radiyallahu anhu was on the top of this what? This behavior. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I heard the rumor, the people are rumoring that you are about to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, if this is true, please allow me to be the one who kill him. Why? He said, because I am afraid. He said, you know how dutiful I am to my father. You know how much I love my father. I am afraid that some Muslim will kill him, and I will never endure it, and I will kill that Muslim. Again, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we are not going to kill your father. Just go be what? Nice, dutiful, at disposal of your father. That's why, ya akhwa, we tell you all the time, if the enemies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who had their information not second hand or third hand, Allah knows man, how many hands, they know Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the true Muhammad, in no time they will be Muslims. If not Muslims, they will be very, very admirers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They will know. Now, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul, you know, after the battle of Badr, let me read to you the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari before we go. We read this hadith, of course, you know this hadith, we studied the Seerah from A to Z, the authentic reports. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never, never forget, never, never forgot any favor. Never, and never came short in returning the favor many, many times better. The hadith goes like this. This I'm reading Sahih al-Bukhari, Kitab al-Jihad, Babu al-Kiswa lil-Asara. Sahih al-Bukhari, the book of Jihad, subtitle, clothing, the prisoners of war. It goes like this. And Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu anhuma qal. Jabir, the son of Abdullah, may Allah be pleased with him, and his father said, Lemma kana yawm badr, utiya bi asara, bi usara, wa utiya bil abbasi, wa lam yakun alayhi thawb. Says, during the battle of Badr, or after the battle of Badr, the prisoners of war were brought forward. And among them was Al-Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when they brought him, he did not have a garment over him. He was in his, as they call it, underwear. Underwear.
He fought against the Muslims.
Of course. Remember, we studied him in the Seerah, the generosity of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the money came so much, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, give me money because I paid for my ransom and the ransom of my nephew Aqil. You remember? He fought against him. Yes, fair and square. So he was brought. Do you remember we said what? As-Sahaba al-Kiram said, Ya Rasulullah, allow us to forgive Al-Abbas his ransom. Said, not even one single what? Dirham. No favorism. So he was fighting against the Muslims. Yes. Or at least he was in the camp of what? Of the kuffar, in the army. So he was brought to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And he did not have an overgarment. This is the thawb, ya. The one I'm wearing is called what? Thawb. It's called qamis, called dirah, ila akhiri, ila akhiri. Allah knows why, but you know, from ancient times, what do the soldiers do after they lose the battle, or if they want to run? Huh? Say what? They took off their what?
Uniforms or whatever.
Exactly. They took off their war gear. Especially any uniform that can identify them. So it's possible that he did that. Okay? But when he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he came with his what? Without his out garment. فنظر النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم له قميصا. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم looked for him for a قميص. This is also the قميص. فوجدوا قميص عبد الله بن أبي. يقدر عليه. يعني على المقاس. مقاس مين؟ مقاس عبد الله ابن أبي ابن أبي سلمة. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم, when he saw him this way, he looked for a قميص for him, for an outer garment, and they found that the قميص of عبد الله ابن أبي ابن أبي سلمة was his size. فكساه النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم إياه. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took that qamis, asked Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul to give him the garment, and they gave him the garment, the outer garment, and what? Dressed to addressed Al-Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib radiyallahu anhu. قال فلذلك نزع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قميصه الذي ألبسه. And إن شاء الله this will lead us to the story how رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم treated عبد الله ابن أبي ابن أبي سلول. He tried his best to be nicest with him even after the death of عبد الله ابن أبي ابن أبي سلول. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took off his outer garment, his qamis, and what? And dressed Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul with it. قال ابن عيينة سفيان ابن عيينة قال ابن عيينة سفيان ابن عيينة ابن عيينة كانت له عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يد يعني معروف فأحب أن يكافئه. The sub-narrator Sufyan ibn Abi Uyayna said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did that because he did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a favor, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to what? To return the favor. Now, let's go to the heart of the lecture. Why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took off his garment first? First, let's go to Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari and read. We're going to read the narration from Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab and the narration of Umar ibn Abdullah Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhuma in Sahih al-Bukhari. We read. Please pay attention to see the kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma, on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, anna Abdullah ibn Ubay lamma tuwfiya jaa ibnuhu Abdullah ibn Abdullah. When Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul died, his son Abdullah ibn Abdullah came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال يا رسول الله أعطني قميصك أكفنه فيه. يا رسول الله, give me your outer garment so I would shroud my father with it. Wow. Whoa, 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 whoa. قميص وفي عبد الله ابن أبي بن أبي سلول. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم boarded from who? From him to dress a prisoner of war who happened to be the uncle of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah never forgot that favor. So give me your outer garment. For what? So I can shroud my father, رأس المنافقين. رأس المنافقين. يا أخوة, death ends all battles. Never forget that. In Islam, death ends all battles. خلاص. Done. Give me your shirt, your outer garment, so I can shroud him with it. وصلي عليه واستغفر له. And يا رسول الله, and please pray on him and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. The sworn enemy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sworn enemy of the Muslims, the sworn enemies of Islam, the one who did a harm to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beyond a description. فأعطاه النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم قميصاً. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم gave الصحابي الجليل عبد الله ابن عبد الله ابن أبي ابن أبو سلول his قميص, his outer garment. فقال له إذا فرغت منه فآذني أصلي عليه. He said, once you finish with him, let me know, so I will what come and pray on him. فَآذَنَهُ. So Abdullah, the Sahabi, came back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him, I'm finished with him, he is ready. فَلَمَّا أَرَادَ أَنْ يُصَلِّي عَلَيْهِ جَذَبَهُ عُمَرُ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stood to offer the prayers on him, who grabbed him from behind and pulled him? Umar ibn al-Khattab. رضي الله عنه فقال أليس الله قد نهاك أن تصلي على المنافقين تصلي عليه وهو منافق وقد نهاك الله أن تستغفر له. He said, Umar al-Khattab came, grabbed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he pulled him. Stop it, what are you doing? Has not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade you from offering salatul janaza on the munafiqun? At that time, this was the understanding of Umar. At that time, offering salatul janaza on any kafir was not yet forbidden.
Not yet.
Nor the istighfar. Came what? Later on. He said, are you about to offer the salah on him knowing that he is munafiq? And knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade you from asking Allah to forgive them. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا بين خيرتين. He said, no, until this moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me two choices, two options. قال الله تعالى استغفر لهم أو لا تستغفر لهم. إن تستغفر لهم 70 times فلن يغفر الله لهم. Verse number what? 80, Surah Ayish, At-Tawbah. He said, no, I have got two choices. Allah said, ask Allah for forgiveness for them, or do not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Even if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 70 times to forgive them, Allah will never forgive them. But if you want to go ahead and ask, be my guest. This is in reference to verse what? Verse number 80, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, استغفر لهم أو لا تستغفر لهم إن تستغفر لهم 70 مرة فلن يغفر الله لهم ذلك بأنهم كفروا بالله ورسوله والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين. Ask forgiveness for them, O Muhammad, or do not ask forgiveness for them. If you should ask forgiveness for them 70 times, never will Allah forgive them. That is because they committed kufr. They disbelieved in Allah and His Messenger. And Allah does not guide the what? The defiantly disobedient people, the sinners. Okay? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam corrected him. He said, you misunderstood. That was not a prohibition. Yet, it was what?
An optional.
فَقَالَ سَأَزِيدُهُ عَلَىٰ سَبْعِينَ. He said, I am not going to pray for him, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him 70 times. Rather, I'm going to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more 70 times. Yeah? قَالَ فَصَلَّى عَلَيْهِ وَصَلَّيْنَا مَعَهُ. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after this exchange with Umar radiallahu anhu, he offered the salah on Ra'as al-Munafiqeen, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, wa sallayna ma'ahu, and we, sahaba al-kiram, they joined Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in offering salat al-janazah, funeral salah, on who? On Abdullah ibn Abi Salul. On Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul. Yeah? فنزلت ولا تصلي على أحد منهم مات أبدا ولا تقم على قبره إنهم كفروا بالله ورسوله وماتوا وهم فاسقون فترك الصلاة عليهم. Then after that, verse 84 came down, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? ولا تصلي على أحد منهم مات أبدا ولا تقم على قبره لماذا انهم كفروا بالله ورسوله وماتوا وهم فاسقون. And do not pray the funeral prayer, O Muhammad, over any of them who has died ever or stand at his grave. Indeed they disbelieved in Allah and his messenger and died while they were defiantly disobedient, open sinners. Look at the kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the kindness of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As long as there is a glimpse of hope, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took advantage of that glimpse of hope to pray for who? For the munafiqun, for the hypocrites. Not just any hypocrite, this is the chief of the hypocrites. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul, Ra'as al-Munafiqeen. Not just anyone. Second part of that, in kindness to his son. In kindness to his son. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْمَيِّتْ فَدَعُوهُ. We told you what death ends all wars. He said, once a person die, leave him. خلاص, he's dead. He's with Allah. And he used to say what? لَا تُؤْذُوا لا تؤذوا حيا بسب ميت. لا تؤذوا حيا بسب ميت. So do not harm a living person, especially if this living person is a Muslim. By what? By insulting what? a dead person.
Yeah. My father is a kafir. My father is Abu Jahl. Yeah. Abu Jahl is gone ila jahannam wa bi'sa al-masir. His son, example, Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, sitting around. Oh, you remember your father is Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl al-la'ina fi jahannam wa bi'sa al-masir. Why? He's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. End of the story. لا تؤذوا حيا بسبب إيش؟ ميت. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam showed the utmost kindness and generosity and compassionate, not for the munafiq only, but before that to who? His son. Abdullah ibn Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul رضي الله عنه وأرضاه رضي الله عنه وأرضاه and of course return the favor to give what the shirt back. I want to read to you the narration of عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه. Look at the narration. I'm not still reading from Sahih al-Bukhari. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. On the authority of Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him. Annahu qal, that he said, لما مات عبد الله ابن أبي ابن سلول. When عبد الله ابن أبي ابن يبي ابن when عبد الله ابن أبي ابن سلول died, دعي له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليصلي عليه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was called to pray on him. فلما قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وثبت إليه. And when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم stood up to offer the salah, I jumped him. I what? Jumped him. فقلت يا رسول الله أتصلي على ابن أبي يا رسول الله are you about to offer the salah on ابن أبي يعني ما بقي غير تصلي على ابن أبي وقد قال يوم كذا وكذا كذا وكذا أعدد عليه قوله جزاك الله خير حبيبي الله يبارك فيك يسد ها يسد are you about to صلي يعني أنت about to صلي are you about to offer صلاة الجنازة on the son of Ubay the one who on the such such day he said such and such and such such day he said such and such and he said such. He said I was what counting to him opening the what the can of worms of who of Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Abi Salul فتبسم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم smiled like you need to remind me of this I do not know you thought I forgot the pain he inflicted the pain he inflicted is way beyond what forgetting maybe forgiving but forgetting It's impossible. وقال أخر عني يا عمر. He said what? Step back away from me, عمر. Enough is enough. فلما أكثرت عليه قال. And when I pushed him, I kept going back and forth. You are praying on. Are you about to pray on him? He did this. He said this. قال إني خيرت فاخترت. He said I've been given the choice. To do it or not to do it, and I chose to do it. لو أعلم أني إن زدت على السبعين فغفر له لزدت عليه.
If I know that if I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70, if I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times to forgive him and Allah will forgive him, I would do that. قال فصلى عليه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وسلم and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وسلم after that offered صلاة الجنازة the funeral صلاة on him. ثم انصرف. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وسلم left. فلم يمكث إلا يسيرا حتى نزلت الآيتان من براءة and after a short while the following two verses of Surah Bara'a, Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, were revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مَاتَ مِنْهُمْ أَبَدًا إِلَىٰ قَوْلِهِ وَهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Do not pray on anyone of them who died ever to the saying of Allah because they are sinners. قَالَ عُمَرْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ فعجبت بعد من جراءتي على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يومئذ والله ورسوله أعلم. Then after I reflected on that, I was wondering how I إجراءتي
يعني.
دير. الله يبارك فيك. I was wondering from my daring of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. At that day. How did I dare to do this to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? I'll tell you how. First, because the pain was so much in the heart of عمر. Second, because he misunderstood the verse. He misunderstood the verse. That's why he said, وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَعْلَمْ. Then I found out that Allah and His Messenger know best. What is the moral lesson, Ya Akhwana? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rahmatun lil alameen. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mercy to all the creatures of Allah. And we have to be mercy to all the creatures of Allah within the Sharia. When there is time to be harsh, there is time to be harsh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Jahid ish, al-kuffara, wal-munafiqina, wa-ghluz alayhim. He said what? Make jihad against the kuffar and the munafiqin and be harsh to them. When they are carrying the sword to cut your neck, now that's a different story. Once the sword is laid down, all the mercy can be mustered out for the sake of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. If you have any questions, corrections, or other concerns, we'll entertain them in the remaining time. Otherwise, Jazakumullah khairan for coming and Jazakumullah khairan for listening. And please, Habibi, post it as soon as possible. Many people are waiting for this.